Hello everybody, Video Lancer is on. Today, I will show you a simple life hack on how to do a smooth echo effect. To compare, this is what a classical variant looks like. We'll consider two examples today. The first example is slow-mo footage captured with a tripod. Due to the static background here, it will be easy to make a nice motion trail. The second example is also slow-mo, but captured by a dynamic camera. In this case, we should separate the background. Otherwise, the echo will look this way. But before we start, I'd like to announce a small competition. Just watch this video to the end and find out how to get $100 from me. So let's start our tutorial. Create a new composition from your footage. Add the echo effect to the footage layer. Select Composite in Front Mode in Echo Operator. Other settings have to be configured individually for every video, so that the nearest frames could be as close to each other as possible. As you can see, the echo effect looks like motion blur that doesn't have a sufficient number of samples. Let's fix it. Add the pixel motion blur effect above the echo. Now the echo effect looks smoother, but sample steps are still visible. To improve this result, temporarily disable the echo effect. Customize pixel motion blur so that samples could be seen but not so obvious. These settings can also be individual for every definite video. If you switch on the echo effect, frames rendering takes a considerable period of time. The fact is that pixel motion blur creates intermediate frames, and this affects the performance. In my case, 30 intermediate frames are created. To work more comfortably, I recommend making a pre-render for this video. So make sure that the echo effect is switched off and add this composition to Render Queue. Select JPEG Sequence in the Output module. Choose the Output folder and click Render. Import the ready sequence in After Effects. Make sure the frame rate of the sequence matches the frame rate of the composition. Select the footage layer and drag the sequence on it, holding the Alt key. Here, delete Pixel Motion Blur and switch on the echo effect. Now the motion trail looks great, but let's add one slight improvement. Duplicate the sequence layer and delete the echo effect from it. Set layer opacity to 25%. Now the original frame can be seen more distinctly, and the motion trail effect looks more expressive. Next, we are going to consider the example with a dynamic camera. If we add the echo effect on such a video, the full image is blurred. But we need to add echo effect only to the character. For this purpose, we should remove the background. It can be done by any most convenient method. In my example, the best solution will be roto brush use. So duplicate the footage layer. Name it Character. Name the lower copy BG and temporarily turn it off. Double-click the character layer to open it in an individual window. Select the Roto Brush tool. Beginning with this frame, draw the silhouette of the character. To change the brush size, move the cursor holding the Control key. To remove a poor selection, move the brush holding the Alt key. If contours come out too rough, it's not a problem. Such a mask is enough for the effect we are creating. Now, pressing the page down key, a mask will be created automatically on each frame. Improve the mask shape along the timeline where it is required. Go back to the initial frame and do the same for the previous frames. Press the page up key and improve the mask if it is required. Go back to the composition window. Make Pre-compose for Character Layer. Switch on this checkbox and click OK. Next, repeat the same steps we did in the first example. Also, add this composition to the render queue. But instead of JPEG, make pre-render to PNG sequence with alpha channel. Import the ready sequence in After Effects. make sure that the sequence frame rate corresponds to the frame rate of the composition. Drag the sequence to the character layer holding the Alt key. Delete pixel motion blur here and switch on the echo effect. Switch on display of the BG layer. That is all. But wait, I will tell you how to get $100 from me. In the next video tutorial, I will show my exclusive method of creating a really cool motion trail effect. Before the tutorial release, leave a comment with your idea of achieving this effect. If there is already a similar tutorial on the internet, you can just add the link. Among the options that will be most suitable, I will randomly choose a winner and send him $100. Well, that was Video Lancer. Good luck!